My friend said I should just have picks, like, scattered all over, like, all the surfaces of my immediate area.
That would be very cool.
It's a good idea, but I only have 4 right now, and I'm keeping them in the same place. Which does mean if I lose them, I lose probably all of them.
Yeah.
But, since I have 4 and I'm trying to decide, like, how each pick affects what. Spend very little time practicing that.
Okay.
But you see how easy it is to, like, I mean, I know I'm making mistakes, but you see how the basic level of it is really easy?
Yeah. You never know when a bowl of steaming noodles will come in handy.
Yes. First two parts last time, and
yeah, and then I just replayed them.
Okay, so I really need a new pick.
Oh.
Listen, this other one that I got is really strange. Listen to the sounds it makes.
Oh, I see what you mean.
Told me that most people who start learning guitar start with something called vinyl strings, which I guess are easier to play, and I don't know if like this is for that, but you hear it like click every string.
Yeah.
I'll go back to the yellow one, maybe since I had some time on football. Yeah, the yellow one's dead.
How can a pick be dead?
I don't know. I don't know how this works.
Okay.
Sorry, I mean, I can speculate. I can say, like, over time it gets bendy or something. You know how, like, it's supposed to be solid and it gets flexible?
Yeah, okay.
But it... I don't know. Yeah.
I love you.
It's one of those, yeah, things.
It's one of those, yeah, things?
Like, it's one of those things where technology is indistinguishable from magic.
Okay.
Kind of thing. See the horrible grooves in my hands?
Yeah.
Like,
okay.
Look at that one.
Yes. But you are good.
But it's all...
If you think it's too much, then don't do it.
No, I know. But what you're saying is that it's supposed to be like that?
I think it's okay that it's like that.
Alright, okay. Getting to the part where I'm starting to abandon like minor parts of what I was practicing before.
That you're already good at?
I'm either good at or I'm not interested in playing them. Is that...
Yeah.
That's normal, right?
Yeah.
Like you choose a new thing to explore and...
Yeah.
But there's like the obsessive part of my brain that says like, I can't stop exploring this, like learning... Specifically, it's like there's 5 or 6 chord shapes for A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Okay.
And I had it in my head that I was going to like memorize firmly, like really firmly memorize them. And I've gotten to the point where some of them are very firmly memorized, some of them need work. Some of them I have to consult the picture to remember what they are.
Okay.
And I'm caring less and less about whether I achieve my goal of like 100% memorizing these chords. And
that's,
even if
that's
I...
That's probably good though, I think that's good. Like, I would think that means you're like getting to be more of a player and less of a just like...
A mechanic.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I also think if I were to really wanted to root them in my memory, I'd have to go past the part where I can play all of them immediately with ease, and go to the part where I've been playing them with ease for like 7 years or whatever.
Yeah.
And then at that point, if I gave up guitar, like, I could, like, ride a bike.
Yeah.
So does that make sense?
It does.
But yeah, I think that the way a lot of people approach guitar is, I don't know, I'm still in the basics, but I think I can compare it to, like, there's like you set yourself a goal to learn something, you learn it, and you move on to learn something else. I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah, no,
I understand. That makes sense.
I don't know.
That's so... I don't understand. But like,
I don't know.
Thank you.
especially the E chords. You know how for a long time I was going...
Yeah.
With the E chords, I've gotten to the point where... I mean, I could be making mistakes by doing this, but I've gotten to the point where I just play them. Like, it counts as practicing them by playing them.
Yeah.
Do you think that's okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good point. I'm tired.
Probably.
But yeah, I was gonna say my brain does these weird things. Like the last video I filmed, remember what people call jamming?
Yes.
I don't like to call it jamming. It's just like improvising. When I was doing that, my vision was like, I was defocusing my eyes to the point where it was getting darker in the room. I don't know if you've ever done that.
Maybe. I don't know.
But, it was a little frightening, but it felt natural. Like, I thought about the fact that, like, blind people have other senses heightened. So if I was defocusing my eyes to a level of blindness, people are going to call bullshit on this. Like, it sounds unbelievable, right?
Sort of, yes.
That, like, I would be turning off my eyes so I could hear.
Okay. It makes some sort of sense. It just makes kind of weird sense.
Yeah.
Sounds like when you're crazy thoughts.
Yeah. But also I have these weird sensations in my brain when I'm, like, learning something. And I think those are normal, and I just have not been learning anything at all for a very long time. Like, when was the last time I've read books and stuff, but, like, when was the last time you think I actually learned something?
Well, sometimes I teach you things.
No, yeah, well, I learn, like, tidbits, but I mean, like, the way you study chemistry or whatever.
Yeah.
Like, that's like dedicated learning, and it's different from like reading a Wikipedia article and thinking about it, you know?
Yeah, that's true.
Anyways, I was gonna stop the video.